We all came to the court today wearing the new Wilson Rush Pro 3.0.
We just wrapped up our playtest of the Wilson Rush Pro 3.0s. Now, I've playtested every version of this shoe, and when I slipped it on this 3.0 version on my feet, it felt very similar to the previous versions. I found it to have no break-in period for me. I thought the uppers were nice and soft, so I didn't have any rubbing. And I thought it was maybe a medium fit. I have narrow width feet, so I had a little bit extra room. I thought there was good cushioning underfoot as well.
I also have playtested a few versions of the Rush Pro, and unlike the 2.5, which I found to be a little bit narrow for my wider forefoot, this shoe was really comfortable right out of the box. There was no break-in needed. The uppers of the mesh fabric is super comfortable, almost slipper-like, and just got more comfortable as the test wore on.
Yeah, for me, it was my first time wearing a Wilson shoe, so I didn't really have any expectations from the shoe. Surprisingly, it was actually very comfortable, and it did not compromise overall support. The tongue is attached to the insole, which I think adds this lateral support that I need to move aggressively on the court. The cushioning was very soft. Like you said, the mesh fabric made the shoe very comfortable and also made the shoe very flexible.
Completely agree with you guys. That step in comfort was amazing. Really soft uppers, which leads me to one issue I had with the shoe was a lot of toe jam. And I also wonder if it's because the support just wasn't supportive enough. The upper was just too loose on my feet. How did you feel about the support?
I was right there with you. I think because that upper was so soft and I have a narrow width foot, I was moving a lot of forwards and backwards in the shoe. And so I wasn't getting that support I needed on aggressive movements. And then the toe bumper is a little bit hard, so I was getting a little bit of toe jam on those really aggressive movements.
Yeah, I also, I don't have the narrow foot, so I didn't have that toe jam right away. It took a few hours once the uppers started to relax a little bit, I'd say 3 hours, and then I noticed a little bit of toe jamming. However, I thought the stability actually was really good, and even when I was pulled out really wide, the uppers were soft, but I was still being held well, moving side to side.
I also experienced toe jamming as well, and I think that's really the feature that kept this shoe from being an excellent tennis shoe. Coming to durability, I noticed some smoothing after about like 8 hours of play test, which is actually not bad knowing that I'm wearing my shoes out pretty quickly. And I really enjoyed the traction. It was never too sticky. I experienced a few slides, but it was always smooth and controlled. So the traction was actually perfect for me.
And I think the last thing we want to talk about this shoe is the weight. It's not going to be the lightest shoe out there. I do feel like it feels a lot lighter than previous versions of the Rush Pro, so that was an awesome benefit as well. Now, if you want to learn more about this shoe and many others, make sure you visit us at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.